Hello, and today we are with Mr. Sukamal Mondal, who is the General Manager of the Oriental Residence Bangkok. Good afternoon to you, Khun Sukamal.
Good afternoon.
Now, Bangkok, Thailand actually recently has had a few incidents where some unfortunate bombings in Phuket and Hua Hin, and some incidents here in Bangkok as well. How have you as a hotel here in Bangkok been affected by these incidents, and have you had any cancellations with regards to forward bookings?
Actually, surprisingly, so far we haven't got affected, Oriental Residence Bangkok itself. Well, there are actually quite a lot of inquiries, quite a lot of phone calls, what's going on, and they wanted to check if their reservations can be changed to another date. But so far, no cancellations and no amendments in arrivals. So we are quite okay.
Well, that's good to hear. Now, in terms of the location of this property, you're not a new property, but some people will not know where you are exactly. Where exactly is this property, and what is the advantage of being in this location?
Actually, I must say that this place has the perfect location. We are actually situated in the Wireless Road, which is very near, let's say 5 to 8 minutes walking distance to Planchet, and also Central Chitlom. Yet we are not in the city, but we are a little away from the city, so the location is perfect. It's totally tranquil and quiet.
Now, of course, SkyTrains is a priority. In terms of, for example, the SkyTrain, how close are we to a SkyTrain here?
We are actually 5 to 8 minutes walking distance, so if the guest wants to walk. However, surprisingly, there are a lot of guests prefers walking, and so far they have no problems. However, we actually offer offered van as a transport shuttle bus throughout the day from 8 a.m. to until 8 p.m. Every 30 minutes we run the shuttle bus. So far the guests, we have both kind of guests where they take shuttle bus or sometimes they prefer to walk as well.
Now, I didn't realize just how much land basically the American Embassy and the Dutch Embassy have got, because of course when you're staying at this property you're right next door. But also there's another green lung of Bangkok, as it's called, Lumpini. In terms of recreation, what are some of the recreational facilities around the property?
Well, actually we have a running road map. Every morning we set up in the lobby with bottles of water and fresh fruits for our guests. We offer them running maps, which we actually tell them how to run from here to the hotel, from hotel to Lumpini Park, and also the way back. But that's very popular among the corporate guests, surprisingly, because they prefer to not go to a gym using the treadmill, but using Lumpini Park as a real life. And it has got a lot of good feedback.
Now, in terms of the name of this property, residences, they're becoming very popular, service departments, residences. How do you differ from a hotel, and what is the thinking behind the name residence?
Well, the name Oriental Residence Bangkok, it's actually a true meaning. We are luxury service residents, so we actually offering exactly same luxury service level as a hotel is offering to our clients. We are actually giving an add-on value, offering the same services as a hotels, but at the different setup where actually guests can come and stay with us, especially corporate guests or leisure guests. They come and stay with us. They can have their own space, so they can have their own entertainment also after a hard work day for a corporate guest, for example. They have a fantastic evening. They don't have to go back to the restaurant. They can come back to the apartment and can order their room service. So we are offering exactly same as a hotel residence, but in a luxury level.
Now, in terms of the different room categories that you have here, because you have suites, but you also, how have you broken down the different room categories here at the Oriental Bangkok Residences?
We are offering four basic room types, starting with a grand deluxe room, which is our smallest unit, which is 45 square meter, follows with a one bedroom suite, which is 70 square meter, and two bedroom, 120 square meter, and we have got three bedroom suite, which is 180 square meter.
Are all of these available for short term, as in one night or two nights, and long term rental as well?
We are offering both short stays and long stays, always available.
Now, in terms of the guests that are staying here, how many of your guests are coming here for business and how many are leisure?
We actually got a very good mix. I would say 45% of business, which is corporate clients, meetings, incentive groups, and the rest 55% will be leisure.
And in terms of markets, because of course, as we mentioned, there are a lot of embassies around in this area. It's a very prestigious area to be in. Where are your top five markets from, and how are you looking to possibly differ that as we move forward?
We are actually in the Wallace Road, so definitely we are located just beside US Embassy. Definitely US market is our top market, but surprisingly after US, following the rest of the four top nationalities are Asian actually. I would say Taiwan, Singapore, Malaysia, and Hong Kong, and China. Definitely, that's the fastest growing market.
Now, you yourself, you've worked in China, you've spent a lot of time there. What did you learn from your China experience that you've been able to bring to this property to be able to make the guests from China that little bit more welcome?
Well, the most important thing is I lived there for 12 years. I speak Mandarin. So definitely my language speaking skills actually definitely helps a lot. We do have a Chinese speaking guest relations and also in food and beverage, you know, one of our restaurants. However, I'm always there there to speak with the guest. I generally spend my time, some part of the time, always meeting the guests. So definitely that helps. They always feel happy. How come I don't look like Chinese, but I speak Chinese, so that helps definitely.
And in terms of, for example, the technology, how are you using technology to help in that way? Are you using e-menus and this type of things to help the Chinese guests and other nationalities be able to understand what the menu is in their own language?
Actually, it's a very, I think this question is very popular nowadays. This question has always been asked, so I'll be ready to answer you. Is I personally prefer personal touch. Technology is definitely good for any hotels, but to some extent, having an e-menu is not that difficult. But however, I personally think, or as the Onyx Hospitality Group, we think that personal touch is very important to maintain the service. We are also looking at it to update our technologies in the room. However, e-menus and self-check-ins, we are not there, and as a group, as an Onyx Hospitality Group, we may not go there in this kind of luxury service residence, because we still think personalized touch, personalized service is the best to know our guests and their needs.
In terms of distribution, because of course everybody's fighting to get the direct business now, but you still have the OTAs, the online travel agencies and what have you. How much of your business is coming direct at the moment, and what is your target for 2017?
Well, as an overall group and including our property at Oriental Residence, we have got a fantastic mix of online travel agents, wholesales, leisure markets, and also the most important is our direct bookings from our website. So it has got a very good mix.
And in terms of trade shows, do you as an individual property attend trade shows and go on road trips?
We do visit most of the trade shows around the world. Definitely we participate as a group, as an Onyx Hospitality Group.
Now, I know you have an F&B background.
Right.
You have a very interesting setup here. You have two restaurants, basically. Could you tell us a little bit more about the F&B that you have?
Oriental Residence Bangkok, other than our service residence part, food and beverage. In the town, we are kind of top of the town in terms of we have got the best Café Clair restaurant, which is a French bistro style, quite popular for breakfast and also quite popular for our afternoon high tea. And also to mention that we got very nice setup for our weddings. So we do exclusive, small, not a huge amount, but we do small groups of weddings. And also we are quite popular in terms of, so we are the one who launched the pastel theme colors for the weddings and engagements.
Which means what, sorry?
Actually, we've got our own event team. We personalized all the events according to their guest needs. So for example, if a couple walks in, we gave them exactly what they need. We just ask them their requirements and we make their dreams come true, because you know, weddings and engagements, these are one of the most important part of life. And so far me and my team actually did a fantastic job in making memories, and we did make lots of memories.
Who's going to get married here? Are these Thais or are these people coming in from overseas?
Actually, well, I would say 90% the couples, we are doing the event, we are all Thai couples. However, because of our popularity, we do get sometimes couples, small groups, let's say 20 to 30 rooms, do get from outside Thailand too.
Now, you also are one of the very few hotels to have a chef that has his own restaurant here, but it's still part of the hotel. You can still sign for it. Could you tell us a little bit more about the Michelin-starred restaurant that you have?
This is definitely one more attraction for our hotel, and it adds value. Mr. Hank, Chef Hank Savelberg from Netherlands, he's actually opened his own restaurant, which is called Savelberg. We actually chose him to be a part to open his first restaurant in Thailand. So we are actually the first person to bring Chef Savelberg in Thailand. And so far, with all the guest feedback, I must say that it's not food. A lot of guests say that it's a kind of art. So definitely, it tells me that the food is good.
Are you able to, because with a restaurant like this, of course, it requires the local community. Do you get hotel guests as well as the locals coming in, or is it just hotel guests that are dining there?
I would say they're a mix. I mean, on and off, there must be sometime there are a lot of hotel guests, there are sometime lots of outside guests. But I would say I think they have a very good mix of both hotel and outside guests as well. Because in Bangkok, Savelberg, as a restaurant, it's quite popular now. So it's in town.
Now, as you mentioned earlier, this hotel is a member of Onyx Hospitality Group. What does that mean to a guest? What advantage does that give to a guest that is staying here?
I would say over 44 years of experience with all the talents we have. Onyx Hospitality Group actually currently running around 32 properties around Asia. So definitely Oriental Residence Bangkok being a part of Onyx Hospitality Group is, I think it's fantastic because we are able to give luxury service, luxury, every single thing we can offer to our guests is because we are a part of a group. It has definitely has lots of values in terms of management, in terms of services we are offering to our guests. Yes.
Now, I know that you're very proud of the beds that you have here at this property. Everybody's competing for the best bed in the industry. And of course, it is very important. Frequent travelers, they arrive somewhere, they're going to spend more time in their bed, hopefully, than they will anywhere else in the property. Tell us about the beds that you have here at the property, please.
I think sleep is very important, especially when we are actually offering, we are getting lots of corporate guests. A good night's sleep gives you a fantastic day ahead, you know, for a corporate meeting. So for us, as a group, we focus a lot on beds, a perfect sleep, actually. Our mattresses are being designed according to our requirements. We actually focus on health benefits, too. So these mattresses are cone mattresses, and it has got lots of good comfort.
And you have an extensive menu, pillow menu, I've noticed as well.
Definitely, and I must say, pillow menu is very hot. People love it. In fact, their guests, they try. I mean, they may not need sometimes, but they do try all the types of menus. If they stay 3 nights, they sometimes try 3 or 4 pillow types.
Is there a favorite? Which is the most popular?
I would say I've got 2 favorites. I mean, based on guest requests also, the foam mattress, and also there is... there's a herbal pillow as well, and also there will be a pillow which will actually shape according to your neck, and that gives you a very nice sleep. I do use that.
Now, finally, you have a background in F&B, we've discussed that. You've worked in China, famous for its dim sum and other foods. What is your favorite place here in Bangkok for dim sum, and what are your favorite 3 Thai dishes that you recommend that every tourist traveler to Thailand should try?
Well, Hong Pao, I think. I've tried many times. Hong Pao is actually a restaurant. It's a Chinese restaurant chain. They've got a lot of areas. They have in one of our sister property at Amari Watergate, and also they have one in Central Embassy, which is very near to our hotel. Definitely one of the best Chinese food you can get. I do miss Chinese food sometimes. I do crave for, so I definitely visit Hong Pao always. Talking about best Thai food, I know there are a lot of touristic Thai food is there, so if you ask me to tell you, I actually do love lots of Thai original Thai food. But out of my favorite, the 3 dishes, I would definitely say Yom Som, which is a pomelo fruit salad, and also Nam Tok. Nam Tok is kind of a grilled meat, and it's served with rice flakes and also onion. So Nam Tok is quite popular. One of the best dish I do love is actually it's kind of a fried fish. It serves with mango sauce. So it's pla thot. It's called pla thot. Pla is like fish and thot is fried. So it's a fried fish served with fish sauce. So it's pla thot nam pla. Definitely it's worth trying. Fantastic.
You're making me hungry. Khun Sukamal, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, I wish you and the Oriental Residence Bangkok the best of luck for the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you.